Gentlemen, I hope you can hear me. I welcome all of you to this one-of-a-kind seminar, which is probably being held for the first time in the city of Kolkata. Today we will be listening to a lecture on the power of the subconscious mind, and we will also gain an insight into the world of the unknown and beyond. Our speaker today is Professor Manish K. Wadla, MBBS, MD, a histopathologist by profession and an expert in past life regression. He has lectured on the subject in many places throughout the world. With his profound knowledge and his deep insight in his chosen field, he has touched the lives of many people he has come across. A perfect gentleman to the core, he never tires of counseling people who come to him in spite of having a back-breaking professional schedule. We were fortunate to have Professor Wadla as our classmate. We have known him for the last 44 years, and he has remained his humble self all these years. I'll request Professor Wadla to come on stage, please. And I'll request Harsha Sen to please welcome Professor Wadla. Thank you. Now over to Professor Wadla. Thank you.
Disturbs a lot of people. So before we begin, all of you who are here, I would just like to ask you, what brought you here? See, apart from those who came just to see me, that is one thing. If you have any other question, what was it that made you come here? What did you have in mind? Anyone? Which? See, this will be more of an interactive session. It will not be a talk. I am here to answer many of your questions and give you an insight into a perspective which I discovered, and I would like to share it with you. Maybe it's going to help you in your life to solve a number of issues. Some people came out of curiosity. Some came because of me, I know.
Interesting subject.
The subject is interesting. And before I go on into the depth, remember, just imagine that there is a knock on your door and you open the door and you see a stranger standing there. So what are you going to ask that stranger? Who are you? What do you want? Why is here? So if I ask you the same question, who are you and why are you here on earth? So when this question comes, everybody starts thinking. It is, you are disturbed. You really do not know who you are. You have taken a name, profession, people know you well, but who are you actually? Okay, you are a human being, but everybody in the universe is only human beings. What is special about you and why are you here? So the stranger tells you the same thing, I don't know who I am and why have I come here, I don't know. भी पागल नहीं है यहाँ पर आ गए पता नहीं है क्यों कौन है और यहाँ पर क्या करते हैं आज चिल्ड्रन रोम अराउंड प्ले अराउंड स्टडी बिकम बिग मैरी एंजॉय ग्रो ओल्ड डाई बट इज दिस व्हाई यू आर हियर विद दिस क्वेश्चन I started discovering exactly the question is. This is a question which has been going on to the minds of mankind for years and years. Who am I? I'll just try to make it a bit simple. Of course, there are a lot of complications and options to all this. You consist of a body, a mind, and a soul.
All of you know as Atma.
And we also know that Atma is there. If we talk about who am I, so we have a body, we have a mind, and we have a soul. We know the body dies, that you die, the body dies. And with that, a part of the mind that we call the conscious mind also dies. And there is a soul, as we have heard that the soul is eternal, cannot die. Once the person dies, the soul is released and goes away. The next question is, soul is released, the person dies, the soul is gone. Where is it? Again, the question is, goes into another body? No. It's not that bodies are waiting and the soul comes out of the body. So there is a system for all this. The physical world where we are living is what we can call the realm of the self, the realm of the physical world. And when the soul dies, when the body dies, the soul goes to the other side, and that is the soul goes to the, let us call it the other side. It's written as goes to heaven, goes to Shambhala, goes to Paramdham. You can give it any name. Now, if we talk about where the soul goes, we call it the realm of souls, or the place where you stay after your death and before your next birth. Heaven, you can call it heaven. Okay. Now, that is a place where the soul, being eternal, doesn't have a body. That is the place where, which we all know is heaven, where there is everything is good, there is no pain, no injury, no disease, everybody is happy, there is peace. And that is where we actually stay. So we don't die, that is the eternal place, that is our body. And this world where we are is a school. Where we have come over here to learn. And then it must be going on in your mind that if we are in a place where everything is so good, why do we want to come here? You have all the theory, everything is fit, you know everything which is going on. Suddenly you say, okay, mujhe wahan jana hai. Actually, you come here to do your practicals. And the things you come here to learn are actually the higher emotions. Emotions of forgiveness, love, gratitude, compassion, kindness. These things, even though we all know that these are good things, once you give the practical and you pass the practical, only then you go to the next place. So let me make it a bit more clear. Suppose you decide, okay, I cannot forgive people easily.